Hey tubers, Big Kid here from archersfriend.com and bigkidreviews.com. I'm going to today show you some sight work I've been doing on an H&R 1871 model single shot 4570.
Hey tubers, Big Kid here of archersfriend.com and bigkidreviews.com. I've had this rifle for a while. I got it because this happens to be the H&R 1871 model, and in a 4570, and the Buffalo Classic. I got this thing because I wanted to start participating and do a little black powder cartridge rifle shooting. So I just had to have one, and the heavy, expensive ones, the high wall, low wall reproductions of the old classics just wasn't in my budget, and way too much to spend to get into the sport. And this was an affordable starting point, but when I got it, the problem was the sights weren't adequate for 100 yards. You had to hold too high. So I started playing with the sights and whatnot. And I believe that this is what was the standard rear sight with it. I'm not real sure. It's a Williams type. But when it just wasn't adequate. You couldn't shoot long range with it. And I needed to be able to shoot 200 or 300 yards with a decent sight. And this wasn't going to cut it, so I kind of lost interest in it. And then over time, I decided that the easiest way would be to raise this base up instead of having it mounted to the gun. So I got a scope base, a Weaver style, and got it to where it would work on here. And then started adapting the Weaver base so that this Williams sight would fit it. And as you can see, hopefully, I'll zoom it a little bit, but I have modified the hell out of this with my milling machine a little at the time, just playing with it, working with the screw holes and whatnot to get them to line up, and got that mounted. And I guess I haven't been back out to test it. I don't remember. I've had it too long. But anyway, the front sight, I don't know if that came with it or not. It's an adjustable insert type, or if I added that. It's just been too long. I don't know what it comes with anymore. But anyway, back to the problem at hand. I still wasn't convinced that that's going to be what I need. There again, I can't even remember if I've gone out and shot it since I've put this thing on there. And you've got some ramp left with it, and I'll do some more experimenting. But anyway, I came up with this other thing I found online, and it's made for your AR-15 platform. I better zoom this back out. And it's got a flip up deal here, and it can get down to the real fine target sight, or you can flip it maybe, and you can see how it does. And then the big one, great big monster, comes up for real close range. You know, if you're going to be buffalo hunting or something real close, you want to be able to see pretty good in it, so you can flip that up. But it's, like I say, for an AR-15, and it's was supposedly to fit a Weaver. Well, it's to fit the AR-15 platform with the rails on it. It won't fit this because of the bolt, cross bolt here. When I measure that bolt diameter, I get 0.18 of an inch. And when I measure these slots in this Weaver mount, it comes out to be a 0.13. So although this will go on there, where, you know, 5,000's in a whole bunch, or 500's, I guess. It's not a whole bunch of difference, but it is still considerable. And although this will clamp on, it doesn't go down as far as I would like, and I just want it to be more secure than what it would be. So what to do? Well, the old big boy, the old country boy, big kid, country boy method is the poor boy operation. And rather than take all of this off, when I had such a hard time getting it to fit, I decided I wasn't going to take it off. And if I did, I'd have to jig it and spend a considerable amount of time getting this in the milling machine could go in there and widen this out, and it would be time consuming. So you true machinists out there probably have a heart attack about what I'm going to do to fix this, or try to fix it. But it's going to be the poor boy method, down and dirty, and I'm convinced it'll work. But here's what my plan is. I've got a drill bit set, it's a numbered drill bit set, and so it's pretty small graduations and steps. So what I've done is I've taken found a bit that is, let me pause real quick. Okay, we're back. What I did was I measured that with the calipers, and I've got me a drill bit here that's a number 22 drill bit size, and it's a point, let me try that again. Okay, the point, or the 20, number 22 bit is about 0.15, so that's around 2/1000ths difference than what this is. So what I'm going to do is take a battery powered drill, chuck this 0.15 in there, and slowly lay it into the slot on each side, and that'll make it a little bit bigger. And then I'll go to the next size up and make it a little bit bigger, and just do this in steps a little at the time, and see if I can't fix it so the bolt will seat correctly and get more meat on this dovetail to clamp her down, and see how that goes. Now, I know you machinists are going to have a frickin' heart attack over it, but, you know, this is what I'm going to try, and I think it'll work, and we'll be back in a little bit after the first attempt. Okay, I got this bit chucked up in this battery-powered drill. Now, drill bits aren't created equal, and a lot of times they're not real straight and true. Another reason for starting extra small. And then the chucks on some of these inexpensive drills are not real true either, and they have some wobble or run-out. Another reason. So you got two things there that's going to cause you, or probably cause you, some grief. So you start very small and work your way up, measuring each step with the part that you want to fit, just so your run out or wobble. You know, we got 2/1000ths different measured, but in reality, once you start running this drill bit in there, it may be quite a bit different than that. So we're going to do a little at the time and see what happens. Okay, we're back. And what I did was I had measured my drill bit numbered sets, and the number 14 bit measured the 0.18 in my set, which is what I needed. But with the wobble, the run out, and all that crap, I started small. I started with the number 22 bit, which measures 0.15 on my set, and then I made my cut, measured it, went up a different size. I went up to the number and steps. I got up to the number 16, which measured 0.17 on my drill bit set, and tried it, run it through there, and you know, I still had two more to go for the right size, but with the wobble run out and whatnot, that got me close enough where I'm satisfied now. I want to bring up a couple of more things to you. This little headgear thing that jewelers use with the magnifiers and whatnot, this one's got little headlights and stuff. If you don't have one of those and you fiddle with guns or reels or small parts or watches or whatever, you got to get you one of those. They're not very expensive, and boy, they are some kind of handy. Now, I'm going to show you one other little trick. When you put something like this together, and oftentimes you got to take off this clamp, and when you take it off, you got to pay attention to put it back on correctly. Let's get down here, maybe that'll work better. You see those bevels are different, and you got to be sure it matches up, and that's the way it goes because it matches this slot right here on the sight part itself. Now I'm going to, if you turned it over, it would be a little crooked. It wouldn't clamp down correctly. So I'm going to turn this off, put it on the gun, and then show you what that looks like. Okay, I've got it mounted on there, and you can see that clamp is fitting those angles really, really good. There's no point in trying to get it any better than that as far as I'm concerned, because with the run out and the wobbles and the chuck and the bits, it'll get too sloppy. Now this is a good snug fit. You can look down inside. I'll put the flashlight down. Now you probably can't see it. Down inside there when you raise the gun up, and you can look at how that bolt seats lays in the slot down in there, and it's just as good as it's going to get. So that's where I'm going to stop. Now, the way this sets, I can actually use this original one and look through that slot. And let's see if you can see this or not. But there's a slot there, and once you get it up to your shoulder, you can actually see this rear sight, look through there, and see that front sight, and I'll see how much usability that is. But I've got me a tall sight. It was fairly inexpensive. I got this AR-15 flip sight mount for less than $30, and there'll be links to where I found that in case you ever want to do something as silly as this. And later on we'll go do a test one of these days when I get more time and just see how all these things come together and what works and what doesn't work. But that took me maybe 30 minutes being real careful start to finish, and now I have me a tall sight, and I didn't have to pay hundreds of dollars for it, and I think it'll be pretty useful. So there'll be links to all where I get all these parts and stuff on the bigkid.com site and under the review of this project. And as usual, we'll see you in the mountains. Hit that subscribe button. Got more crazy ideas in the works. Never know what you might find. Might save yourself a bunch of bucks. You might just turn your stomach. Who knows? Hit the subscribe button. Big Kid signing off for archersfriend.com and bigkidreviews.com. And see you in the mountains one of these days, and see you on the next video. Adios.
Well, that's about it for this one. Hope you didn't mind looking at the poor boy method of sight installation. I think it's going to work. Hit the subscribe button. See you in the mountain. Come back soon.